Space Patrol! High adventure in the wild, vast reaches of space. Missions of daring in the name of interplanetary justice. Travel into the future with Buzz Corey, Commander-in-Chief of the Space Patrol.
Space Patrol is brought to you by the delicious bite-sized checkerboard cereals. Wheat Chex, Rice Chex.
Stand by for exciting action on The Manhunt on Pluto 3 in just one moment.
Come on, Captain Barkley, what does it say?
In just a second, Hap. There are too many people crowded around the bulletin board. Uh-oh, it's coming into focus now. It reads, Last Call for Space Patrol Periscope.
Smoking rockets, that's right. Today's the last day we can tell the gang about the sensational Space Patrol Periscope. So you better send for yours right now, gang, because you don't want to miss out on all the neat fun you can have with a periscope.
Yes, and remember, it has two wonderful magic mirrors. One on top and one on the bottom, so you can see around corners. And it's a big 24 inches high, so you can see over fences and over the heads of tall people. And it's tapered to give you that wide-angle vision you want when you're peering around trees. And all the time you're peering through your periscope, you can see, but nobody can see you.
And say, gang, look here, this neat identification chart on the back that shows you what all the weird space characters might look like on all the major planets. And on top, a place for your name, address, and solar system.
So send for yours today, Space Patrollers.
Jump in Jupiter right now, gang, because this is the last time we can tell you about this terrific Space Patrol periscope.
Just send a Rice Chex or Wheat Chex box top, together with your name and address and 25 cents in coin to Space Patrol, Box 812, St. Louis, Missouri. That's Space Patrol, Box 812, St. Louis, Missouri.
Now, don't forget your 25 cents and your Rice Chex or Wheat Chex box top.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Bite-sized Chex taste good to me. Bite-sized Chex, Wheat Chex, Rice Chex. Get your checkerboard cereal today.
Pluto 3, the third satellite from Pluto whose orbit describes the outermost boundary of the solar system. A green, fertile body with a temperate climate produced by the conductive warmth of inner volcanic action. Here, Buzz Corey and his cadet Happy have rescued countless victims of the evil Dr. Frederick Kurt from a lifetime of slavery in his core of giants. Having restored the men to normal with the energy converter, Buzz and Happy stand by in the battle cruiser flown in by Major Robertson, who has returned to Pluto 3 to transport the liberated victims back to their homes.
Well, the passengers are all aboard soon. You never saw a happier bunch of guys in your life.
Boy, I'll bet they should be glad to get back home again.
That's putting it mildly, huh? Oh, by the way, I Space Phone Terra notified the families of the men that were on their way. And unless I miss my guess, there's going to be a big welcome home ceremony for one Commander Corey.
I'm afraid that'd be a little premature, Robbie. Happy and I aren't going back to Terra.
Do you not?
Why not, sir?
Because I think Dr. Kurt and his giant Atlas are still here.
On Pluto 3, sir?
Yes, or near it.
Why do you say that, sir?
Right after we saw Dr. Kurt's ship blast off, I sent out an all units alert. That was hours ago. Not one trace of his ship has been reported.
Smoking rockets. With every unit in the system out looking for him, they should have reported something.
They would have, had, unless Kurt didn't go anywhere.
That would sure explain it all right, Commander.
Well, where do we start looking for him, sir?
Dr. Kurt's sanitarium. We may have other units here on Pluto 3, and we'll look around there. Might find something that'll give us a clue.
Well, if you find him, be careful of Atlas. I can tell you from experience, he's strong as an elephant. I almost lasted 10 seconds with him.
I'll get the shock rifles. Yeah, these will stop him, all right. And they're fully charged, too.
Well, you want me to stay with you, sir? Give you a hand?
Oh, no, thanks, Robbie. You might contact me by space phone when you get back to Terra.
Right, sir. On my way.
Good trip, Robbie. Go on, Hap. Let's see what we can find at the sanitarium.
Right.
Atlas, you have your orders. Go quickly. I'm blasting off immediately.
Okay, Robbie. All clear. All right, back there. Stand by to blast off.
Nothing in here either, Commander. Maybe he's outside, hiding in the trees.
Unless he's still in the ship up there, circling this moon.
Commander, what's that?
That's a missile. Get down!
Run, Hal! What happened?
No, we found Kurt.
Yeah, or else he found us.
Let's get out of here, fast.
Commander, that was a close call.
Not near as close as the one Kurt's going to have me get this ship upstairs.
Why do you suppose he's blasting his own sanitarium?
He's desperate now. He's out for revenge. Because we ruined his racket.
Trouble with that guy, he hasn't got any sense of humor.
Oh, Atlas!
I anticipated that you might escape from the sanatorium, so I left Atlas here to greet you.
So you've greeted us. Now what?
Now, my revenge.
Oh, you're through, Kurt. Why don't you give up?
Never. You have destroyed me, and now I'm going to destroy you. And I'm going to enjoy every minute of it. Now get in these seats, both of you, and blast off!
Stand by, Hap.
Standing by, sir.
Fire rockets.
Fire rockets.
You're going to turn us loose?
You heard it right, Corey. I'm going to turn you loose in a place called Hunter's Canyon. Of course, you'll have no weapons.
Needless to say.
And you may have a little trouble staying alive.
All right, Kurt, what's on your mind?
Take a look down there, Corey. You see the high cliffs surrounding the canyon from all sides but one?
Yeah, it looks like sort of a box canyon.
There's no way out except through that little narrow bottleneck entrance. And that's where you will land the ship, Corey. Right across that entrance. Locking it off. And then, as I promised, I'll turn you loose.
Thank you.
Well, what are you waiting for? I said you would be turned free when we landed.
Free?
Yes, free, Corey. Free to live at Hunter's Canyon. As long as you can stay alive.
I thought you said we were going hunting.
Almost. You are to be the hunted. The prey of the hunter.
What do you think we are, a couple of Martian jackrabbits?
What I think doesn't make any difference. It's entirely up to Atlas.
Atlas? What's he got to do with it?
Atlas is the hunter.
What?
He will stalk you until he hunts you down. And I will stay here guarding the entrance to the canyon with a shock riser to be sure you don't escape.
Oh,
I give
you
10 minutes. Just 10 seconds. Head start until I send Atlas after you. Now go. Go before you force me to fire.
Come on.
But Commander.
Come on.
Around corners, over fences,
and from behind trees. You can see, space patrollers, but you'll never, never be seen if you'll send away today for this sensational Space Patrol periscope. The honest-to-goodness periscope with the two mirrors that work like magic, so you can peer at your pals and they'll never know you're doing it. And all the time you're peering through your periscope, you won't miss a trick, because it's tapered special for wide-angle vision. It's big, too, 24 inches high. Say, if you take a trip into outer space, you might meet up with a Martian or shake hands with a Saturnian. You'll know who they are from this identification chart of outer space characters printed right here on your periscope. But space patrollers, you've got to hurry. Get those box tops and quarters in the mail now. This is the last time I can offer you the official Space Patrol periscope. Today, send a Rice Chex or Wheat Chex box top, together with your name and address and 25 cents in coin, to Space Patrol, Box 812, St. Louis, Missouri. Offer good only in USA and may be withdrawn at any time. That's Space Patrol, Box 812, St. Louis, Missouri. Don't forget your 25 cents and a Rice Chex or Wheat Chex box top.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Bite-sized Chex taste good to me. Bite-sized Chex. Wheat Chex. Rice Chex. Get your checkerboard cereal today.
And now, back to Space Patrol.
Smoking rockets, Commander. Nothing but sheer cliffs all around us. We can't possibly scale them. Get Kurt sitting back there with a shock rifle to make sure we don't get out of this canyon. And Atlas, the giant, he's hunting us down like a couple of wild animals. What are we going to do, Commander?
We're not through yet, Happy. Our best chance is to separate and go deeper into the canyon, then circle back, try to slip up on Kurt.
Oh, yeah, maybe we can sneak up on him from different directions.
That's the idea. We'll keep in touch with Miniature Spaceophone.
Right, sir. Uh-oh, here comes the hunter.
Don't let him get his hands on you. Good luck, Hap.
Same to you, sir. Happy, do you read me?
I read you, sir.
I circled back to the same spot we just left. Atlas went in your direction. I would put him somewhere between you and me.
That's kind of the way I figured it, Commander. I heard him crashing down through the... Hey! Oh!
Happy, what's wrong? Happy!
Hap, answer me. Where are you?
I fell in a pit, Commander. I think I sprained my ankle.
I see it. It'll be right there.
Where's Atlas?
I haven't seen him yet.
Mm.
the opening's covered again.
You think we can get Atlas to walk over it and fall in?
We better. Here he comes. Come on, Atlas. Come and get us.
Come on, musclehead. Rockets, Commander. We did it. He fell in the pit.
Don't stay there long. Give us a chance to find a hideout, though, and take a look at your ankle. Come on, this way.
And meantime, back at Terra City in the Space Patrol building, Major Robertson, having said goodbye to the last of his passengers, checks into headquarters to make a spacophone call.
Major Robertson to Commander Corey on Pluto 3. Major Robertson to Commander Corey. Over. Major Robertson to Commander Corey. Do you read me? Come in. Come in. Major Robertson, Space Control.
Space Control. Go ahead, Major.
Request clearance. Battle cruiser, Pluto orbit, 3 minutes.
Didn't you just come in from Pluto, Major?
Yes, I did, but I've got to go back.
This should do it. You think we can squeeze through that narrow opening?
Well, we can, but I don't think Atlas can.
Take a look at that ankle.
Well, it sure doesn't help the situation much, does it?
It's all right. We're safe in here, at least for a while.
Maybe Atlas didn't get out of the pit. Maybe he knocked himself out when he fell in.
Major Robertson to Commander Corey on Pluto 3.
Done a good job on his ankle. Smoke the rockets, Commander. He's got us tracked. Blast this ankle on your radio.
To hurt himself, but he fell in the pit. Seems to be a little weakened.
Don't get too close to him, Commander.
Maybe I can weaken a little more.
Don't try it, sir.
Try to wear him out.
Smoke them rockets. Commander's out there getting himself killed, and there's nothing I can do about it. Hey, wait a minute.
Maybe there is something I can do.
Commander's ship doing down there.
Major, the commander, commander's fighting Atlas all alone. You better go help him.
I hope I'm not too late.
Take that shock rifle. It's the only thing that'll stop him.
Right. Here, keep your eye on Kurt.
Right, sir.
Commander, where are you?
All right, Atlas. Send him to the... You or me?
Commander!
Commander. All right, Robbie. Just a little tired.
What happened to him?
That's why I'm tired.
And don't forget, Dr. Kurt, just because I've got a sprained ankle, that doesn't mean I can't use this ray gun.
What are they doing in my sanatorium?
Well, they're just finishing the little job that you started. They're blowing it up.
They destroyed it?
Sure. That's so it can never be used on anybody else again. Oh, hi, Commander. How you feeling?
I'm all right, Hap. Stood a little out of breath.
Even Atlas couldn't slow the Commander up. He's already got me in conference. Come on.
Conference? What about?
Well, that new experimental rocket ship I was telling you about the other day, the XRC. We'd be testing it now if it weren't for Kurt's interference.
Hey, Hap, we've got a mock-up of that rocket cockpit if you want to see it.
Wow. Say, that's terrific. Boy, I sure hope I get a chance to check out in it.
Oh, Robbie, here's the control I wanted to point out to you. You see, all the way on the right side of the panel, you have the time computer, the gamma protective shield, projectile forward rockets, inverse directional indicator, and starboard rocket.
Yeah, but,
real handy thing for the pilot.
Look out!
Happy, what are you doing?
Hey, I did it. Oh. I did it all by myself. Me, Cadet Happy. I knocked Atlas down.
Happy,
wow.
I hate to disillusion you.
Muscles of steel. Wow.
But before we destroyed the energy converter, we used it on Atlas. He's been restored to normal, just like all the other victims of Kurtz.
Oh, one punch happy, they'll call me.
He's no longer a powerful giant.
That's what I say. He's no longer a powerful giant. He's... What'd you say?
I said, meet Mr. William Gray.
Mr. Gray?
Yes, he was formerly Dr. Kurtz's lab assistant. He was his first victim.
Oh. How do you do, Mr. Gray?
Hello, Cadet Happy.
You...
Oh, giant killer.
In just a moment, a preview of next week's exciting Space Patrol adventure, which will be brought to you by Nestle's Ever Ready, the instant cocoa and famous Nestle's chocolate bars.
Hi, Space Patrollers. You know, whether I go to the moon or the planets, forward or backward in time, I always head for the galley whenever I get home. It's because I always like a good hot cup of Nestle's Ever Ready cocoa. I sure go for that sensational Nestle's chocolate bar flavor. And that wonderful taste that's, well, it's so chocolatey rich. I sure like the way you can make it in an instant. Look. Just put 1, 2, 3 teaspoons in your cup. Add hot water. Stir. And there it is. Nothing to add, because whole milk and sugar are already in it. Nestle's Ever Ready is a perfect way to start your day and finish it. So why don't you ask Mom to get this big red and yellow can of Nestle's Ever Ready? And say, better save the lid. You'll need it next week for our big surprise. Well, now, I'm going to have my Nestle's cocoa. How about you?
And now, a scene from next week's exciting action, The Theft of the Rocket Cockpit.
Smoking rockets, Commander. There was only one model of that top secret rocket cockpit ship, and, well, now Stanger's stolen it, and he's got it back in the past somewhere, and, well, he's stealing the design.
Yes, Happy. If we don't stop him, he'll soon have enough time drive ships to outfit his entire crime syndicate.
Be sure to see what happens when Buzz and Happy get involved with a 20th century atom bomb when they try to prevent the theft of the rocket cockpit. Next week on Space Patrol! Space Patrol was brought to you today by the bite-sized cereals in the red and white checkerboard packages. Rice Chex and Wheat Chex.